Ladies and gentlemen, presenting from Northwest London, England, the self-proclaimed A-Force of Lee Harrison!
We keep writing him off, don't we? Still keeps coming. 41 years old now. And if he wins this, well, he's back in the mix. That is the short of it, and that is what it is. That is what this fight is about. If Harrison can get past this raw, big punching American, he just might get another chance. And having seen him knocked out by David Price in, what was it, 82 seconds, I didn't think I'd be saying that. Such are the vagaries of boxing. And Audley Harrison has sparred Deontay Wilder, he's worked with him, and he reckons that he can do this tonight. Be a lot of very, very big plans derailed if he did. He says he's got his fighting mojo back. He's got himself into shape.
What you need to realize,
and at the weigh-in, I thought he looked really good.
What you need to realize, that is my destiny.
I'm not going to be foolish enough to say last chance for Audley Harrison, because he just keeps coming back, doesn't he?
He does, and after you saw him get caught by David Price in that fight, you'd never dream in a million years that you'd see him in a big fight, in a meaningful fight like this again, but he came back, one prize fight, and there he is again.
The reception he's getting is mixed. If he wins this one, they will raise the roof, because the public... I know a lot of boxing fans don't like to admit it, but the public love this guy. He has got crossover appeal.
How can you not like someone that keeps bouncing back after those losses?
Ladies and gentlemen, in tandem with his bomb squad, here comes the undefeated heavyweight sensation from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, USA, the Bronze Bomber,
Bomber. This is the Bronze Bomber. I'm sure he'll have had one eye on history when he picked up the big game. Six-foot-seven, a huge heavyweight. Trained by one of the best fighters I've seen, Mark Breland.
Great fighter.
Quality fighter.
Great fighter.
Wilder's a bit of a motor mouth as well, as you may well find out a little bit later on. He just keeps blitzing everything in front of him. He's won all his 27 fights inside 4 rounds.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is 12 3-minute rounds of an international heavyweight contest. The officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control. Steward in charge at ringside, Charles Giles. Timekeeper at the bell, Barry Pinder from the Steel City of Sheffield. The three scoring judges at ringside for this special featured attraction are Steve Gray from Fleetwood, England, Phil Edwards from Preston, England, and Marcus McDonald from Twickenham, England. Finally, when the action commences, the star referee in charge of the action, truly one of the world's finest, Mr. Terry O'Connor from Birmingham, England. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the blue coloured shorts. After weighing yesterday, he scaled 16 stone, 12 pounds, 7 ounces, or 236.7 pounds. His excellent professional record consists of 37 contests, 31 wins, 23 of those wins coming by way of knockout with only 6 defeats. As an amateur, he struck gold at the 1998 Kuala Lumpur Commonwealth Games gold, 2000 Sydney Olympic gold medalist, and as a professional, he comes to the ring this evening as the former heavyweight champion of Europe from Northwest London, England. The journey continues for only A-Force Harrison. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the purple colour shorts trimmed with gold. At the weigh-in yesterday, he scaled 16 stone, 8 ounces, or 224.8 pounds. His excellent undefeated record, 27 contests, 27 wins, all 27 of those wins coming by way of KO. At the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games, he struck a magnificent bronze medal. As a professional, he comes to the ring this evening as the WBC Continental America's Heavyweight Champion from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, USA. Here is Deontay, the Bronze Bomber Wilder. Mr. O'Connor with his final instructions, 12 three-minute rounds.
Watch you in the changing room, protect yourself to all times. When I say break, I want it straight away. Shake hands, best of luck to both.
First round is going to be all important, as we know, or as we knew, and as we learned against David Price. Audley Harrison froze against David Hay by his own admission. Here he's against this fella, who is absolutely rock hard. He saw his physique. Very, very long and lean. Here we go then. Wilder versus Harrison. Harrison's spent time in the gym with Wilder. He knows what he brings. He says the right hand's dangerous, but that he's got the tools to deliver. Tentative opening from both men. Literally just feeling each other out with that jab. There's the right hand, that's the big shot. And he goes looking for Harrison straight away. One, the first punch he's landed has put Harrison down in the corner.
First
big punch,
six,
put Harrison down.
Seven,
can he get up? Or his legs going to betray him? He manages to get to his feet just. And the referee stopped it. Terry O'Connor stopped it in the first round, the first punch. Wilder has won and the fight has been stopped. The very first punch, he struggled to his feet. Terry O'Connor looked into his eyes and Harrison has been beaten and he is angry.
He just didn't get a chance to recover, John. He got caught and then he got caught with some big cuffing shots out in the back of the head. You know, that was a cracking shot what landed in the first place. I don't think he can have too many complaints about carrying on. He barely just made the count and, you know, he wanted to carry on, that was the thing, but not really in a position to.
There's the right hand, big shot. Well, when he got the opportunity, he almost swung himself off his feet. After that initial right hand, there wasn't much clean landed, I didn't think, Paul.
But it's just these now, see, just on the side of the gloves and cuffing around the back of the head. They'll disorientate it as well. You know, these were a bit naughty on the floor. Wilder's almost on the floor himself throwing them shots. But nice sharp left hook, right hand. And it's David Price's favourite shot, right on the button, right on the side of the temple. Shook all up a bit. He didn't look, you know, he wasn't gone off it, but these shots just sent him over with the force of them. These ones are on the side of the head now. You know, they will shake it up a little bit.
Harrison thought he should have been allowed to continue when he got to his feet. What did you make of it?
I thought he was on very shaky legs. You know, it's heavyweight boxing. The next shot that could land could not only end your career, it could do a lot worse damage. So, you know, it's just one of them things. You can't really argue with any referee in that position.
Well, there'll be those who criticise Terry O'Connor, but he was a heavyweight boxer himself, and he knows what heavyweights can deliver. And Deontay Wilder, well, he found one big shot that was all it needed, and so his blitzkrieg progression through the heavyweights continues. I wonder if this time we might have seen the last of Audley Harrison. I don't know. He keeps on coming back, but what we do know is that Deontay Wilder's made it 28 out of 28, and here's confirmation of that result.
Ladies and gentlemen, after just 1 minute and 10 seconds of round number one, star referee Terry O'Connor has stopped the contest. In his opinion, Audley Harrison was in no condition to continue. Therefore, your winner is incredible. Undefeated record is maintained now. Undefeated in 28 contests, 28 wins from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, USA. The winner, Deontay, the Browns Bomber Wilder.
The United States absolutely craves a new heavyweight champion of the world, and in a sense, might suggest that boxing could do with that. Deontay Wilder continues his progression. He's already ranked in the world top 10. Will he get his chance before too long? Maybe that is the man.
Well, that's a terrific flurry of punches from Deontay Wilder there, but I'm sorry. I just don't get Audley Harrison.
As soon as Deontay Wilder backed Audley Harrison into that position in the corner, the writing was on the wall for me.
David, he's become a novelty act.
Yeah, I know it's easy for people to say that, but you've got to understand that.
Well, he makes it easy.
Yeah, Audley Harrison's probably given his heart and soul in training to get into the ring and give the fight of his life against the young lion.
But that's not enough, is it? No, he's well, got no, to no, do more than
no,
that.
Look, Richard, it's, you know, I know you what you're saying, but the first punch he got it with was a big punch from
a big
strong
punch.
Heavyweight. I know what you're saying, but you know, I'm a heavyweight myself, and I don't want to disrespect any other boxer. If you get hit on the temple with a good shot like that, and you've got a big lad like that in front of you, they're going to try and finish
David,
the job.
David, that must really annoy you. This guy's... that's another big purse he's picked up tonight for nothing.
Look, that's nothing to do with me. You know, I don't care how much money Harrison earns for this fight or whatever. You know, he lost the fight, and that's all that matters. And
but you're a professional boxer, and that brings into disrepute your trade.
I don't agree with that because a lot of fights end like that. It's the nature of the game. It's boxing. One punch can
but
change everything.
But all his end like that.
I heard the noise of that right hand lands on the side of Audley Harrison's head. For me, that was a big shot. And look, I'm sorry. I just don't see what the problem is. He got beat in the first round, and there's nothing can be done about it. He's come into the ring with good intentions. Deontay Wilder, you know, let's give him some credit. He's landed the perfect punch in the right position.
Listen to this.
Yeah, I know, but that's the fans' perception of Audley Harrison's performance. But
no, it's not. It's what they see, David, yeah, time and again.
Yeah, I know, but look, he's got in the ring. He couldn't do any more. Do you know why? Because he literally had the rug pulled from under his feet. He didn't get a chance to get in that fight. And if you get caught cold in the first round straight away with a big shot like that, it's going to be difficult to come back.
Can he not
from.
Do more because he hasn't got it?
Well, look, we know Audley Harrison's underachieved over the years, and he probably hasn't got what he'd like to think he has. But, you know, as far as tonight's concerned, I think we should be more looking at Deontay Wilder as a prospect for the future than magnifying Audley Harrison's performance, because, as I say, I don't think there's anything to do about that, because he come in with all the intentions of making it a good fight, got caught with a good shot, the referee ended the fight, and, you know, he can't do nothing about that. If he'd have got in and held his way through rounds after rounds and spoiled for the whole fight and it being a bore fest, then we could have said, you know what, he didn't earn his pay tonight. But You can't say that tonight because Deontay Wilder got in there and done a number on him. And, you know, you've got to look at it from that point of view.
Let's find out if he agrees. Here he is with Rob Walker again.
Well, Audley, nobody wanted to see that this evening, least of all you.
Yeah, I mean, boy, I felt sharp in there, felt confident. But obviously he caught me with a shot. And I took a knee, but he carried on punching. And I thought the referee would have started to count to eight. You know, so it's like, you know, the guy's throwing punches on me, obviously he put me down. But I got up, I beat the count, and I wanted to continue. And obviously the referee said my legs was all over. But the thing is, when he caught me with that first shot, I went to take a knee straight away. I had my senses about me. And then obviously the follow-up. But I was like on one knee. You know, I was on one knee and he was still throwing punches. So it's like, that's not really fair. So I said, referee, come on, man, why are you stopping? He said, well, your feet were all over. But, you know, I took a knee and I was trying to protect myself. So I still had my senses about me.
So you absolutely felt as though you could have continued?
100%. I wanted to continue. You know, it's like heavyweight boxing, you can get put down. I've been put down and out. But this time I had my senses about me. So I still wanted to continue. You know, so it's like if you're out, if you're out, you're out for the count. But I wasn't out. I said, I'm come on, referee. I'm still, you know, I could hear the count. And I'm like, come on, referee. I'm still in the fight. You know, it's just started. So it's, he was, you know, I felt comfortable in there. I felt comfortable in there. Obviously, he caught me a bit with that one shot. But I took a knee and I was ready to go on.
You've made comebacks before and you really took your time with that ring walk and that entrance. You were absolutely convinced that this was going to be a staging post for another big fight towards the end of the year.
For sure, 100% sure. You know, I definitely felt, you know, I was sharp enough. No excuses there, I was sharp enough. You know Deontay, I've had him in camp, you know he's a big puncher. But I felt I could negate that with my speed and definitely walk him onto a shot. So obviously that was the plan and it kind of backfired on me. But like I said, the fight wasn't over. The fight was just starting, and this time I went down. I kept my senses about me. I took a knee, and obviously he was carrying on hitting me on the floor. But, you know, I'm not taking nothing away from Deontay. But obviously it looked terrible on my part, you know, because obviously I kept myself quiet this time, went focused on training, felt great, felt comfortable, felt calm, and I get banged out. So it's like, you know, it's going to be a hard one. This one's going to be a hard one for me to take because I know all my ducks were lined up for this one, and I was ready to go.
So where next then, Audley? We know you've managed to come back from hugely difficult times in the past, but this is going to be a tough one.
Oh, for sure. I'm not going to kid myself. This is definitely going to be a tough mountain to climb because it took a lot for me just to get back to this position. It took me a lot of fortitude and persistence and to get banged out like this. Obviously, Deontay's 27-0 for a reason. And, you know, now he goes to 28-0. But I really thought I could stop the fire. And I'm just, like, frustrated that I didn't get... You know, the fight should have... I'd have preferred to get carried out there on a straight... Because I was in the shape to go there, so... But, you know, people ain't going to want to hear excuses, and I understand that. But, you know, I fought for everything to get back to this spot, so I can't complain. Whether you want to blame the referee for stopping it too early, you know, the opportunity, I got it by fighting back, and it's going to be hard to come back from here, there's no doubt about it.
So is this the end? Have we seen the last of you in the ring?
Well, I've got to be realistic. I'm 41 years of age. It's going to be hard for me to get opportunities to come back from here. You know, like I wanted an opportunity on the big stage, and I've got another opportunity, and I haven't been able to perform whatever the excuses are. So, you know, it's looking like it could be the end.
Well, if it is, thanks for the journey and unlucky tonight.
Cheers, bro.
He'd be doing himself a favour, Steve Lillis, wouldn't he, if he called it a day now?
I wanted him to retire after he was obliterated by David in 82 seconds, but he never, you know, he's going on about, you know, I fought my way back into this position to get this fight. He fought his way through a prize fighter. Prize fighter's different to this sort of boxing.
I mean, he's talking about having something left in the tank.
There's
after
nothing.
That
there's
onslaught.
Nothing left in the tank.
There isn't anything there, is there?
There isn't left in the tank, and I still think he'll box again. I don't think he'll get another job in this country. I don't think we've seen the last of him. Someone. There'll be a promoter in America who will give him a job.
Let's not talk too much more about Audley. What about Deontay and this swinging power here, Anthony?
There's no doubt in the right hand that set it all off was a massive right hand, and it shows that, yeah, he has got world-class power. But listen, as we're seeing here now, you can still see Deontay Wilder. He's very raw still, the way he's clubbing these shots. You've got to remember, he didn't have that great amateur experience. And, okay, 27-0 before this fight with 27 knockouts is a great record. There's no doubt he can punch. But that was against, you know, a lower opposition. And there's still a lot of questions to be asked about him. However, tonight... He's passed his first big test and he's passed it with flying colours.
Well, let's get a few questions asked of him then. Deontay Wilder is again ringside with Rob Walker.
Deontay, you've answered all the questions, but you were probably expecting it to last a little bit longer than that.
Yeah, you know, I always train for the long run. You know, I always train for the long run. I always expect the best to come out of the opponent at that time. You know, it was a great camp. We was in a great city. My first time here in Sheffield, not my first time in England, but first time in Sheffield, and the hospitality here was tremendous. I loved it. It brought that much more excitement to me just to perform in front of the fans of England. It's been a long time coming. They've been wanting me to come, and I'm here, and I'm super excited.
People were talking about the fact that Audley had more experience than you and that you'd never been beyond four, but you proved that was absolutely irrelevant tonight.
Well, you know, I'm a beast. I'm a beast, and I train hard. I don't have no days off in training. You know, and experience take you only so far, but, you know, when you have a hunger and desire and a will, and you have a goal and you're not just fighting for yourself, it takes a long way. And you got to keep in mind, people don't understand, this is a God-given talent for me. I haven't done all the things I've done and got it thus far, this fast, even in my amateur career. You know, making the Olympic team and medal and being the only one with the least amount of steering in the entire whole Olympics. You know, and this is God given talent. God got a purpose and a reason for me to be here. And I want to display my talent, because if I don't, he'll strip it away and give it to some other brave soul that will do it.
In the lead up to this fight, we've heard you talking about the fact that you believe you're capable of the Klitschkos and you want to call them out. Do you believe you've taken another little step towards getting one of the two brothers in the ring for you?
Oh, most definitely. I took another step. I gained more fans here as well too. So each step is the next step. You know, I'm ready for whoever. This is my year. I done claimed it. It had been claimed for me. Everybody has their due season. God said it may not come when you want it, but it's on time. And right now it's my time. You know, everything is evolving as me as a fighter. The experience as I get in the ring. You know, it just saddens that when I go in the ring, that I know they think about, oh, he got power, because that's all people. Just like Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson mentally got his opponents out of there, and mentally I already had Audley before he stepped in the arena. I saw it in his eyes just a few minutes ago, so I knew it was going to be a good night. But, you know, I want to get that guy that can take me in the deep water so I can show the people what more that I have to offer to Deontay Wilder. Because, you know, just going these short rounds, even though Audley has a lot more experience and gold medals and all that, my purpose is so much higher. My desire, my heart is so much bigger. And that power is, man, it scares me sometimes.
Well, you've clearly enjoyed being in the UK. David Hay, David Price, any other Brits on your radar? Who'd you fancy?
I'll just put it like this. Fee-fi, fum-fum. I'm the man with the right-hand bomb. Tyson Fury. Oh, where? Oh, where can he be? For he's the next man that I want to see. Sheffield, England. Do you agree?
There is nothing else we can add to that. The man of the moment, and it rhymes as well.
Yeah, he wants to get into deep water. We'll take him. Mirage, Vegas, next. Nice. Big right hand from Price, if he fancies it.
He knows how to spoil a good interview anyway, doesn't he? He spoke well till the end. You know what? You know, what he's saying himself there is that he's like, people are watching him go to the ring and they're saying about his power, and he wants to show people more than his power. He wants people to see the other things he's got in his locker, and that's fair enough. And we'll get to see them in time, but, you know, 28 KOs, you can't really argue with it.
Was there anything you learned tonight in that short period of time about him?
Well, to be honest, Audley Harrison, as an experienced fighter, If you watch the right hand from over Audley's shoulder, Deontay Wilder really telegraphed that right hand, and I would have thought Audley would have been able to see that coming. But maybe it's his age, his reflexes or whatever, he didn't see it coming and it caught him. But there wasn't enough time to make a valid opinion of him.